Again.
We superam sarva me modum. Unonis ob ira.
Better here, Lavamaya. Continue his sentence.
Multa quoque et bella passus tu condret urbe.
Every look from the beginning.
Arma urumque cana proiae cimprimus abores.
And robot man.
Italian fato profugus laurique veni.
Estival. Estival.
Sir.
Continue, please.
Estival.
Labinique, menit.
Yes.
Literam, multum. Enim.
Multum enim.
Multum olim.
Olim. Multum olim. So that somehow pious Aeneas has already suffered much in the days still to come.
Hestifum. Do you have any idea of what you're saying, Hestifum?
If you please.
Pardon me.
If you please, Sir Sovereign's teacher. Can't we at least consider multum olim as a plausible conjecture for how the text might read?
Herr Gabor, we are hardly here today to conjecture about textual conjecture. The boy has made an error.
Yes, but an understandable error, sir. Indeed, if we can only entertain the fitness of the conjecture.
Multum olim.
Look to the fresh rhetorical balance. Multum olim introducing multa quoque. A parallel, sir, between what Aeneas has already suffered in war and those sufferings on land and sea just ahead.
Herr Gabor, since the days of Servius, Aulus Gellius, Claudius Donatus, nay, since the moment of Virgil's death, our world has been littered with more than sufficient critical commentary on textual conjecture.
Without respect, sir, are you then suggesting there is no further room for critical thought or interpretation? Why, indeed, then do...
Suggesting no such thing. I am confirming that Herr Stiefel has made an error, and I am asking, nay, demanding that you amend his faulty text and proceed from there. Do I make myself clear?
Deus Latio, the following seven lines of Pius Aeneas' journey from memory.